La pregunta que hizo esta mujer, lee la voz.
Oh, good morning, Jay
Good morning, Yoda,
Sachidana. Yes,
¿cómo
Jay
está?
Sachidana. Jay Sachidana, Luz, Marcela, Patricia, Gaby, Rosie, Sandra, Anila, Shuddhatma Bhagwan. All right, let us begin with the three mantra.
Comenzamos con el trimantra. ¿Quién quiere cantar?
All right, Luz. Let us begin. Yes, Luz.
Namo Sitanam, Namo Ayareyanam, Namo Vasayanam, Namo Loyesava Sahunam, Sopanchanamu Karo Sabapavapanashanu Mangalanam Chasavesim Padamanukabai Mangalam Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namah Shivaya Jai Satchitanam Namo Vitrahaya Namo Arihantanam Namo Sitanam Namo Ayareyanam Namo Vasayanam Namo Loyesava Sahunam Isopanchanamukaro Savapavapanashanu Padamam Havai Mangalam Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namah Shivaya Jai Satchitanam Namo Vitrahaya Namo Arihantanam Namo Siddhanam Namo Ayareyanam Namo Vasayanam Namo Loyesavasahunam Isopanchanamukaro Savapavapanashanu Mangalanam Chasavesim Padamam Pavaimangalam Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namah Shivaya Jai Satchitanam
Jai Sachidan, wonderful. Thank you, Luz.
Hermoso.
All right, now. So let us that begins our satsang for this morning. Session number 81. And we are on page 91. And this it's a 5-6 line paragraph of Dada only. Nobody else, Dada only. And the heading is, in this way the two are indeed separate, is the heading. In this manner, the two are indeed separate. And we talked about extensively in the last satsang, the chapter on sahaj and asahaj. Sahaj means natural, and asahaj means unnatural, unnatural or not natural. So,
Bueno, estamos en la página 81, en la sesión 81, página 91, y vamos a ver este párrafo habla solamente Dada, y el título es: De esta manera los dos están completamente separados. Hemos estado hablando extensivamente en el último satsang de esto, de Sahaj y Asahaj. Sahaj es natural y Asahaj es no natural.
So, there's this word called kriya. Kriya, kriyaraive, kriyaraivai. Kriya means activity of the mind, speech, body. Mind, speech, body, activity, all of that comes under the general heading of kriya. Kriya, doing. You see, is the mind, speech, and body by nature are kriyashil. Kriyashil means that is they by nature they are active. Every mind, every body, and is active by nature. You see, active by nature, naturally active. So it's called kriyashil. So Dadashri says, now Chandubai, now Patricia Ya Marcella is kriyashil, is active, naturally active. You see, naturally active. The body of Marcella is naturally active. The mind of Marcella is naturally active. And the speech also is naturally active. Once a person starts speaking, he speaks the whole sentence, second sentence, third sentence. You see?
Bueno, hay una palabra que es kriya, que es la actividad de la mente, el cuerpo y del habla. Es este, y kriyashil es la actividad de la mente, el cuerpo y habla, y es naturalmente activo. La mente, el cuerpo y habla es naturalmente activo. Ahora, Chandu, Patricia o Marcela están en una naturaleza activa del cuerpo, de la mente y las palabras.
See, the same. So, the mind is active. The body is active. Body is active means the body is involved in activity. The body, by nature, is in some kind or the other activity. Crossing the legs, sitting, moving the hand here and there, blinking the eyes. You see, everything is. Is when you look at any body, anybody, that is the what is visible is the kriyashil activity, is the natural activity of that body. You see, somebody is running on the street, somebody is bicycling, somebody is walking, somebody is working in the garden, etc., etc.
Por ejemplo, la actividad de la mente o la actividad del cuerpo, el cuerpo está involucrado en esta actividad, ¿no? Por ejemplo, ves a una persona y esta persona mueve las manos, las piernas, pestañea, puede estar corriendo, andando en bicicleta, caminando, y puedes observar el movimiento, ¿no? Esta actividad en la que el cuerpo está involucrado.
Kriyashil means that by nature, By nature, it's just like a machine that's running from morning till evening until it falls asleep. And then even sometimes when it
Entonces,
wakes
sí,
up
él es
in
una.
yeah.
I'm not. Sorry. Ay. La actividad Kriyashil es es la actividad natural, ¿no? El cuerpo está en movimiento todo el día, todo el tiempo.
That's right. So, but the other she says, and you. So there's Chandubhai, there is Damian, there is Gonzalo, and then there is you. There are two, right? And so Damian by nature is Kriyashil. Gavi by nature is Kriyashil. Kriyashil means involved in activity, by na nat naturally active, you see. And you are a kriya. When you put an a in front of the word kriya, you become no kriya. In other words, you're a kriya.
Dice también que también Damián y Gonzalo están están involucrados en esta actividad, en Kriyashil, pero tú eres acría. Cuando le agregas una A antes de la palabra, significa lo contrario, lo opuesto. Pero tú no estás en actividad.
So that in fact, let me, the correct sentence here is, you are gnata drashta akriya. In other words, you are the knower seer, you are the knower seer akriya. Not only you're the knower seer, but you are also absolutely akriya. In other words, not at all involved. There is no activity of the Amapura, who is by nature just sincere knower, inactive.
Yes. Entonces tú eres Gnata Drashta Akriya. Gnata es conocedor, Drashta es observador y Akriya es no actividad. Tú en el alma pura no está involucrado en la actividad. Eres el observador conocedor sin actividad.
You see, so you are the Gnata Drashta of the Kriyashil Damian. Damian, Sandra are by nature active. Whatever activity, and there is continuous activity going on, activity of the mind, activity of the body, activity of the speech, and that is its nature. It's kriyashil. It by nature it is active, and you are the knower seer, a kriya, non inactive knower seer. You are the inactive knower seer.
Entonces, Damián, Sandra, tienen actividades, cualquier actividad de la mente, cuerpo o habla, que son naturales, y entonces eso es cría. Pero tu ser verdadero es Gnata Drashta a cría.
Yes, a while ago we were all having a little breakfast. And if you look at the whole processes, so from the getting up until you sit down with your coffee or tea and whatever you eat for breakfast, it's just all this activity is going on. And you're the seer of all of this activity. You see, you are the seer of the activity of what is the activity? You're the seer, S capital seer, of the activity that is going on in the mind. The mind is active, and you are this akriya, the non-involved seer. You are just simply seeing the activity of the mind. Even though the food is being chewed, the mind is independent of the chewing activity. The mind is still running on its own, you see. The two are different activities, you know, activity of the body. Chewing is the activity of the body. The mind is thinking about, oh, you know, this intermittently it will say, oh, this breakfast is good or this bread is good, etc. All right. And so this other is now has brought us to the level where there is a kriya, the activity, and the inactive one. I am the inactive seer, observer of the activities. You see, this is amazingly beautiful because then in this process, nothing that's going on in the mind will touch you. You see.
Yes. Por ejemplo, desde que te, por ejemplo, desayunas a la mañana y desde el momento en que te levantas hasta que estás desayunando, puedes ver, ¿no? Porque tú eres el observador, esta actividad que está sucediendo y puede, y es una actividad de la mente. Y tú eres acría, eres el observador. Y cuando estás masticando el desayuno, puedes estar masticando y tu mente puede estar en otro lado pensando otras cosas. Esa es la parte activa, cría. Pero tú eres acría, eres Ignata Drashta, eres el observador de lo que está sucediendo. Y cuando eres el observador inactivo de lo que está sucediendo, entonces nada te puede tocar.
And what is the activity of the body that's going on? You see, what is the activity of the body that is going on? Is it chewing? Is it chewing? The body, is it chewing properly? Not, you know, you're just the knower of it. Is it? From morning till evening, 24 hours in the night also, you know, the body turns from one side to the other in sleep. You know, you might be able to know that, or you're so asleep that you don't even see that, but the body is moving in different directions, you see.
La actividad del cuerpo, puedes ver que estás masticando bien, no estás masticando lo suficiente, y tú eres el conocedor de eso. Y el cuerpo las 24 horas está en movimiento, inclusive cuando estás durmiendo, el cuerpo puede girar para un lado, girar para el otro o tener algún movimiento.
Sinadashi says in all of this, pote, pote, P-O-T-E-Y, very important word for all of us, especially in the higher Aptavanis, pote, P-O-T-E-Y, pote means, it's that, pote means, the one who is the gnan, the knowledge, the state of knowledge, you know, it's called pote. Pote gnan swarupche. Pote means that I, that before Gnanavedi used to say, I also Sandra, I am Gabriel. That same I in our experience has moved through the Gnanavedi, has become Soyamapura, and that I is now shifted to just knower as the knower. So then it is the same I, the same I, whether or not you have had the Gnanvidhi or not, the same I is always the knower, is the Gnan Swarup, is the knower of everything that is happening. The only difference is before Gnanvidhi we were saying I am knowing this, I am seeing this, my name is Shraddha, my name is Marcella. Now after the Gnanvidhi, There is no name. All names become one. Amapura, Soyamapura. And then in the advanced level states, there is not even the word Soyamapura. It's simply, I'm the knower and the seer of the activity that is going on in this body called Shuddha, in this body called Patricia, etc. See, so this, see how, but the Pote, Potey, remains everywhere. It's there in ignorance as well as in the Siddhagati state, the I.
Potei es es el Potei es siempre estuvo, ¿no? Y ese es un estado de conocimiento. Antes del Gnan Vidin nosotros podíamos decir, bueno, yo veo o yo sé, pero todo con minúscula. Después del Gnan Vidin nosotros sabemos, surge el conocedor verdadero. Y el yo anterior ahora se transforma en un yo con mayúsculas, ¿no? Es veo y conozco desde el Nan Swarup. Entonces, podemos ver que después de ese, antes decíamos yo Damián, yo Patricia, pero ahora es yo, después del Nan Vidi, soy alma pura y es inclusive hasta sin nombre, porque yo soy el conocedor y soy el conocedor y observador de toda actividad que siempre está sucediendo. El Potei siempre existió, antes de recibir el Nan y después del Nan.
I see this. Somebody asks you, Damian, you, Gabriel, or Patricia, who are you? Who are you? You know, this is an internal answer. You know, yes, in the relative, we'll say, I'm Damian, I'm Gabriel, but inside now, our phenomenal, fantastic realization is that in all of this, I am just the knower. I am the non-inactive knower of this entire universe. In this entire universe, I am the inactive knower. I am not involved in any kriya. I am not involved in this speaking and in this answer that Damien gives. He'll say, "Oh, my name is Damien. I live in Argentina, etc., etc." You continue to know the speech of Damien. You continue to know the lips and the tongue of Damien that is moving to give this answer. And you continue to know the thoughts that arise when Damien is giving the answer. You know, you even become aware of the sense that, gee, what do I tell him in terms of who am I? How do I answer who am I to this man who is asking this question? Who are you really? Who are you? You know, who are you?
Ahora te preguntan, ¿quién eres tú? Y esta es una pregunta que es una pregunta interna, porque en realidad soy el conocedor inactivo y no me involucro en las respuestas, ¿no? Puedes verlo, Damián, que está haciendo una pregunta o está respondiendo una pregunta y puedes ver su boca, cómo se mueve. Puedes darte cuenta de sus pensamientos mientras que él contesta,
Yeah,
pero no te involucras, solamente observas y conoces.
you know, another thing Dada says very beautifully when he gives these two magnificent sentences, Pote Gnan Swarup Che, Pote Apudgal Swarup Nathi. Che and Nathi, you know, Nathi means, Che means is and Nathi means is not. Che and Nathi. Pote is not Pudgal Swarup, okay? Che, hun Shuddhatma Chu, or Che, hun Shuddhatma Chu. Che means is, And nati means is not. You see, I mean, this is just for those of you who are getting interested in Gujarati, but simple stuff. Che, are you Marcella? You will say, Hu Marcella Chu. I am Marcella. And, or you can, if you're not Marcella, you'll say, I am not Marcella. Hu Marcella Nati. I am not Marcella. You see?
Bueno, acá Pudgal no, Potei no es el Pudgal Swarup. Y acá trae dos palabras nuevas que es che, que quiere decir que es, y nati, que no es, no es. Entonces dice Marcela, tú eres Marcela y dices Nati, no, 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 Marcela.
In simple words of Dada, you know, these 7-8 sentences, Dada is revealing the experiential state, the state of the experience of this profound, ultimate truth of our existence, you see. Before, we used to be in false existence, believing I am Gabriel, I am Sandra, I am Devadasi, you see. And that was a false existence. We entered our real existence as Swayam Apura in the Gnanvidhi. And now Dada has, in these 80 sessions with Niruma, has taken us to the level of Gnan Swarup. You want to know who I am? I'm the knowledge. I know. By saying these words also, I am actually slipping from the exact way, because these words have to be used. But the Gnan Swarup, how are you going to describe yourself? When you tell others, I am Gnan Swarup, he will say, what? What are you saying? What do you mean? I'm just the knower. I'm the knower. This face, these features, this body, these words is not I. I'm not this. I'm just a knower.
Es. Dada nos revela la experiencia de este profundo estado verdadero, ¿no? Antes decíamos, soy Gabriela, soy Devadasi, pero esa es la falsa existencia. En realidad, después del Gnan Vidhi, sabemos que somos alma pura. Y hoy, después de 80 sesiones, de Niruma, y sabemos que somos en Gnan Swarup, soy el conocedor, ¿no? Y entonces salimos de este estado de ignorancia, solo somos el conocedor. Esta mente, cuerpo y habla no soy, no, no es lo que soy, yo solo soy el conocedor.
Yes. One more final sentence. Okay. And last two sentences I just gave you, which is Dada Shri says, you know, in a sense, for the pote, defined, rather this defines this pote very simply. The pote, Gnan Swarup is in the state of knowledge, K capital knowledge, Gnan. Here you don't, you know what you shouldn't, you know, for because this is for us in Akram Vignan, we call it K capital. But it is really the one in the science of human existence. Every soul within, every living being is the knower only. Is the that pote is there. We have actually entered the state of pote. Pote means not something else. Now I am the knower. I am gnan only. I am knowledge only, you see. And that pote is not this one that fills up and empties, fills up and empties. You see, the mind fills up with all kinds of stuff and then it empties. You see, the mind is hungry. When the body is satisfied, the mind is still hungry. It wants to pick up the newspaper, turn on the TV to fill with information. What's going on? What's going on out there in this world? You see? And then it empties. And then it fills up. And then sense of filling up mind, body.
El pote es el Nan Swarup Chu, es el estado de conocimiento del Nan, es lo que es real, y esta es la ciencia. Y en cada ser viviente está el conocedor, y yo soy el conocedor solamente. Y cuando hablamos de pote aquí, no estamos refiriendo, es el que se llena y el que se vacía, ¿no? Por ejemplo, el cuerpo tiene hambre, come, pero la mente siempre quiere más, quiere saber qué es lo que está pasando, por qué pasa, siempre está hambrienta de saber qué es lo que sucede en este mundo, cómo sucede. Así es la mente.
Yeah, you see, there is say you walk into the magnificent library in Buenos Aires. It's one of the most beautiful libraries in the world, right? I mean, it's a beautiful building. I'm told it's I've never been there, but you have been there. So many books, right? Yeah,
Yes.
so many books, everywhere. That is, and they contain words. You see, those books contain words. Some of those books are holy, sacred scriptures, you see, and others are everything else, history, geography, science, etc., right? None of that.
Yes.
None of. For us now, it is all gnaya. It is something that is being seen, you see. And when Patricia or Marcella reads, picks up a book and reads, that activity also is of the entire Marcella, which has become gnaya. She is reading, she is by nature active, her mind is active, now her intellect is active, her brain is active, she is focusing, concentrating, she is so getting information, she is getting information. But and that is relative knowledge, you see. Whereas this one is G capital knowledge. I, by nature, only know, see, and know everything that is going on. The activity, I see the activity of that which is active. I see the activity of that which is active. I see the activity of the mind of Marcella. The body of Marcella holding the book, you see, checking out the book at the library and, taking it home, again opening it, again reading a few things, right? Activity of the mind. And then after reading a page, the activity will go in another mode, think about all of these things. This is not Gnan Swarup. This is Gneya Swarup. This is called Gneya Swarup.
Yes. Por ejemplo, caminas por Buenos Aires y vas a una librería o vas a una biblioteca, hay lugares muy hermosos y están llenos de libros, pero estos libros solo tienen palabras, pueden hablar de escrituras sagradas, de historia, de geografía. Pero es algo que es visto. Por ejemplo, Marcela o Patricia llegan y tienen esa actividad, se llevan un libro y están leyendo la mente, el cerebro, están en actividad y están tomando información. Pero esta información tiene que ver con el conocimiento relativo, ¿no? Y yo por naturaleza observo la actividad de la mente, del cuerpo sosteniendo el libro, de Marcela llevándose el libro a la casa, leyéndolo, y luego cambia hacia otra actividad. Esto es Gneya Swarup.
And a lot of those activities of the mind has been shifted and now is being presented to us in the form of AI. You see, you can just simply ask Chat GPT, should I, this kind of wheat grows here in Argentina, should I be eating? What is the content and what is the difference between wheat here in Argentina versus wheat in Punjab, India, versus wheat from Ukraine? What's the difference? You see, and it will tell you the differences. And oh, wow, what is organic wheat versus wheat that is produced commercially? You see, so many things you don't have to, in other words, you don't have to now remember any of this. The processing of the mind is not necessary because all the information just gets presents in front of you the moment you ask a question, you see. That, it is the collective brains of this world are now giving you the information, you see, which is called AI, artificial intelligence, you see.
Yes. Las actividades de la mente, ¿no? Por ejemplo, lo que comemos en Argentina, las diferencias, de lo que se come en Argentina, en India o en Ucrania, si son naturales, si son comerciales, todo esto tiene que ver con el cerebro colectivo, ¿no? Y no hace falta que estemos averiguando, porque esta es una información que nos es dada a través de la inteligencia artificial.
In other words, but you do get the information. So if you're interested in the quality foods, high quality foods that are nutritional value and less harmful with reference to, insecticides, pesticides, things that can, over a long term period, may be involved in the causation of cancer. Now, in this kind of activity, you see, you get information because you sometimes don't know, but if you want to get it from the source, like, the collective source, then, it's right there in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you can ask more questions to define it further, you see. And it's as simple as just typing your question or writing something on in chat. GPT, Chat GPT, you see.
Nosotros podemos tener información, por ejemplo, para saber cuál es la comidas de calidad que no hayan sido sometidas a cantidades de insecticidas y cosas así artificiales que pueden llegar hasta a causar el cáncer. Entonces tomas toda esta información y lo único que tienes que hacer es tipear tu pregunta en el chat de inteligencia artificial.
I use the word being known means, you see, now as you and I move away, as we and I are the akriya, inactive knower and seer, of the activity that is going on here in Gavi, in Rosie, in Anila. This activity that's going on, because it is continuous activity, because by nature it is active, because it is by nature active, you cannot say, stop, I want to see you. Stop, I want to see you. You know, it by the you know, it's continuously being known. The knower has infinite knowledge, infinite vision, so it knows, it continues to know, it continues to know, it continues to know. You see, and so one is continuing to show, or continuing to exhibit, or continuing to be there, and then there is the other one inside who continues to be present as the knower. You see, this has become like an amazing final result of the science that is the self. The self is the science. The self has come, is continuing to see and know, instead of getting involved in a mixed knowing state. In the mixed knowing state, I am Patricia and I know what is happening. That is a mixed knowing state, you see, the mixed knowing state. And now, the mixed knowing state, you can only see this much, only very little. In the exact knowing state, now everything appears, everything is seen as it is, you see. As it is.
Yes. Bueno, algo que es ser visto es gneia y es a crían, ¿no? Nosotros vemos la actividad, por ejemplo, de Gabriela, de Rosy, de Anila, que por naturaleza está en actividad. Entonces es le dices, quiere verte o que quiere saber, y hay personas que quieren mostrarse, pero también por dentro están en presencia del conocedor. Y este es el la continua presencia están en continua presencia del conocedor. Este es el resultado final de la ciencia del ser. Y esto es continuo, estar en el observador y en el conocedor sin involucrarse. Si no, entramos en un estado de donde se mezclan el estado de conocimiento, pero mezclado con lo relativo. Y el verdadero estado de conocimiento es ver cómo realmente es.
You know, somebody asked Damien, "Hey, Damien, what's going on?" this is usual language of friends. What's going on? And then
Por ejemplo, alguien le pregunta a Damián, ¿cómo estás, Damián? Bueno,
would...
está en lo diario, ¿no?
So, now this. So, Damien can say, "It's all going on." It is all going on. The mind is going on. The speech is going on. The body is going on. What do you want to know? Everything is going on. The world is going on. What is going on? And you say, then you say, "Oh, I wanted to know how you're doing. How you're feeling? How you're feeling? Oh, you want to know how the mind is feeling? The mind is feeling good." You see, the language changes. You see, the mind is happy. Want to know how the body is doing? Yes, the body is today is fine. There is nothing, as I look at it, nothing is stuck up in any kind of pain. No part is in pain. You see, everything is working smoothly. All the body parts are working smoothly. Right.
Yes.
And what's going on with the speech? Well, so far, the speech that has come out has not hurt anyone. That's all. It's not hurtful speech. I might not be, it has, the speech may be, I don't know to what extent it is helpful, the speech that has come out, but so far, that speech that has come out has not hurt anyone. For today, that's what you're saying. Now, you're in science, you see. But still, the speech is needed for that, see.
Yes. Por ejemplo, a Damián le dicen, bueno, ¿cómo estás? Y Damián dice, todo está bien, mente, cuerpo y habla. ¿Qué es lo que quieres saber? Y quiero saber cómo te sientes. Entonces, Damián, la mente está bien, el cuerpo también está bien, no hay dolor, se mueve suavemente. Y las palabras que salen no tienen que herir a nadie.
Yes.
Puede ser que no sean las más inteligentes son, pero no hay que herir a ningún ser. Dice, por eso estamos en la ciencia y las palabras no hieren a nadie.
Now, this answer will not sit well with your fellow human beings. What? Has turned some kind of a philosopher or what? So you have to, so you have to kind of play the drama, you see. You have to play the part. You just say, you just say, yeah, Dami, I'm feeling good, thank you. I'm feeling good, and you see, then even then you know, you can know and you can see that Damien gave this answer. This is how Damien answered, and that is the correct way. In Dada's language, in the relative, you play the drama, and as the knower, seer, a kriya, the inactive knower, seer, you continue to see what arose. You continue to see what came out. You see what unfolded. Udaya, we talked about Uday. You see Uday,
Entonces vos le contestás así a una persona, ¿no? La mente está funcionando bien, el cuerpo no duele, las palabras que salen no hieren a nadie. Entonces puede ser que haya alguien que en esto no le caiga bien y te diga que eso es un filósofo. Pero bueno, como dice Dada, ¿no? Hay que jugar el papel, ¿no? Play the drama. Entonces Damián dice. Solo contesta, dice, me siento bien. Entonces tú sabes y conoces, y es correcto esta forma, en el mundo de Dada, ¿no? En la forma de Dada, porque somos el conocedor, el observador, sin actividad, y ves todo lo que sale, todo lo que surge, y eso es Udai.
Also, this is how it exactly is. The one, the knower, the one who continue, the knower who is a kriya, the non-doer, is eternally untouched, unaffected by any activity of the Kriyashil, the one who is active. The Kriyashil's activity cannot touch the knower, you see, cannot, because the two are indeed absolutely separate. They are separate. They are separate even in the ones who are who have not received the Jnanvidhi. The only thing is they have not awakened. They have not awakened into their real state. They wake up and go to bed and wake up and go to bed only. We too wake up and go to bed. We too wake up and go to bed. But we are aware of the one who wakes up and the one who goes to bed. You see, we are aware of the Kriyashil, the Kriyashil one. You see.
También es como ver, ¿no? De la exacta forma en que Acría es, ¿no? Es eterno, es intocable, nada lo afecta por ninguna actividad de Acría-Shil, ¿no? ¿Por qué? Porque están totalmente separados. Y esto siempre fue así. Lo que pasa que no. Antes de Gnan nosotros no teníamos conciencia de ello. Ahora sabemos que quién se va a dormir y quién se levanta, porque tenemos la conciencia de saber quién es el que se va a dormir y quién es el que se levanta y quién es el que tiene la actividad.
There is a sentence. Oh, by the way, this paragraph has ended, but this is these are simple sentences, but they are deep, deep, and profound in our science. These are the profound truths, you see, that have been revealed not just as a revelation in a book. This is being revealed to us as a revelation, as an experience. This is who I am. And this other thing is Gneya. This other thing is Pudgal. This other thing is Kriyashil. This other thing is temporary. This other thing will someday be, no, will not be there. I continue to exist as the pure seer knower. I continue to remain. I continue to be present, period.
Yes. Esta es la más profunda revelación como experiencia de quién verdaderamente soy, ¿no? Y todo lo demás es Kriyashil, es temporal. Y yo existiré como el conocedor y observador y estaré presente.
It's so we just pause here. Let's take a little break and then we return, my friends, huh? And thank you, Marcella, for the translations here, and Petri, and then we continue to ask if anybody wants to share or say something about this. Jai
Thank you.
Sachidan. Huh?
Jay
10
Sachidanand. Ayuda.
10
10
minutes,
minutos.
10 minutes, yes.
Okay. Vamos a dar un recreo de 10 minutos y después continuamos con las preguntas que quieran hacer. Justo para mí, este satsang, para Patricia.
About being late, sorry about being late. We're back again and continuing with Dada now. Does anybody want to say anything here?
¿Hay alguien que quiera decir algo, preguntar?
Yeah. Yes, Gaby.
Había una, sí, la pregunta Alicia de pronto primero y después Gaby pregunta o como quieran.
Hacelo vos como quieras, corazón.
Vale, mi pregunta es cortita. Quiero saber cuál es el cachai que está detrás de la sensación del archivo 1 de abuso o de que se están aprovechando de él.
Gabby wants to know which is Kashai that it's behind that somebody wants to abuse or take something from her.
Anger.
El enojo.
Anger is dveshkashai, you see. It's hate. And that
Es
leads to
odio.
hate and abhorrence, you see.
Eso te lleva
Intense.
al odio y la aversión.
And somebody, in other words, that. And it's a combination. It's just not hate, but it's also a combination of. Because they want to take something from you that also is, that is distorted, what we call unnatural greed. It doesn't belong to that person, it belongs to Gabi, but the other person wants to take it by force, you see, so, or through anger or abhorrence, etc. So it's a combination of greed and anger, both. It's just ignorance that creates all of this. There is no light, you see. No light in the effect that is unfolding. Zero light.
Bueno, esto, la primera palabra que dijo fue odio y ira, ¿no? Enojo y aversión. Pero también es una combinación, porque cuando quieren tomar algo de ti es es una codicia no natural, ¿no? Y todo es por la ignorancia, por la falta de luz en el efecto, ¿no?
Yeah, that is how it is. Dadashri calls it a puzzle. The world is the puzzle itself. It has, on its own, it has become puzzled. So the only way out is there are two viewpoints to solve this puzzle. So only the one who has been graced with these two viewpoints, with the vision of the intellect as well as the divine vision of the self, can become free from it, you see. Otherwise, it just continues, my dear, See, Gavi, it was the old Gavi and not the Gavi of Akram Vignan, then there will be more anger, more revenge, more, even if he takes it away, you can't forget it, you see. You can't forgive him, and says more anger, and it continues as a kashai for the next life, you see.
Yes.
Only the Mahatmas can forgive and forget. Only the Mahatmas. Others cannot, you see.
Bueno, dice que Dada dice que el mundo en sí mismo es un rompecabezas, que solamente se puede resolver a través de dos puntos de vista. Uno es la visión intelectual. Y la que te va a liberar es la visión del ser. Esa es la que te libera, ¿no? Está Gavis antes y después del Akram Vignan. Y cuando alguien quiere abusar de vos o lo que Sí, abusar de vos, o tomar algo que es tuyo, no lo puedes olvidar y eso te lleva a generar más enojo y más aversión. Y esto lo llevas a la próxima vida. Y solamente los mahatmas pueden perdonar y olvidar.
Siddhi,
Olvidar.
the file presents with Kashai. A file is exists because there is a Kashai, you see. And against that equanimity of the self, the blissful one doesn't really have to do anything. Blissful one continues to be energized by the bliss of the self, you see. And at the lowest level of that is equanimity. Neither, I'd want to allow this file to come to its natural conclusion without me getting involved in it. The involvement is because of Kashais. So on this side, Gavi does not want to trigger any other. Yeah, Gavi will feel, negative about that person, will feel all kinds of different reactions inside. But with the nine columns, you see, with the natural, with the presence of the self, it clears it. It that file has no ch the file will give its effects and move away, but it will not affect you. It will open. It will express its effects. The files will present with all kinds of bad things in front of you, but it will not affect you, because you are the blessed one of Dada. You are the blessed one of the Gnani Purush, you see.
Dice que los archivos aparecen y aparecen por los kashaes, y contra eso lo único es la ecuanimidad del ser. Y tú eres el dichoso que continúa siendo energizado por la luz del ser. Es resolver este archivo sin involucrarte, y sin tener reacciones negativas, ¿no? Está tener presente los nueve kalams y la luz del ser. El archivo vendrá y dará sus efectos negativos o lo que fuera, pero se irá y a vos nada te va a afectar porque vos tenés la bendición de Dada.
Today's satsang will help, in the sense that which by nature is active, the mind which by nature is active will get involved. The mind will get involved into the activity of that which is unfolding in front of it, but you see it not as negative feelings. You see it as gneya. You see the negative feeling in the mind of Gavi becomes the whole mind, where whatever it presents, it becomes a gneya. It is being seen only. It is being seen as it is. The mind is upset. The mind is disturbed. The mind is now quiet. You see, so this, all of this is continuously seen as a gneya. It's an activity. And the awareness is there that I see it. I see it. I see it. Somebody says, Gavi, how are you feeling? There is no need to. There's no need to tell, oh, I'm seeing Gavi being upset. You don't tell that to other person, because that person will not understand. You can play the drama. I'm disturbed, but I'm okay. I think I can handle it. You just say that I will handle. I can handle it. Whatever you say I'm disturbed, but you don't say It's a drama. You are not feeling that disturbance, you see. When you say I'm disturbed, you're actually saying you are inside immediately, simultaneously, your awakened one, your Amapura will say, Gavi is giving the answers. I am not disturbed, you know. So you say I'm disturbed, but inside it's the drama. It's the exact drama is happening. The drama.
Yes.
Mm.
La actividad de las reacciones, lo que la actividad de las reacciones, lo que ves, no lo ves con sentimientos negativos, ¿no? La mente puede molestarse y tú puedes ver que la mente está molesta o que la mente está tranquila, está quieta. Lo que tú estás viendo es la actividad, ¿no? Tú ves eso. Entonces alguien puede venir y puede preguntarte, ¿cómo estás, Gaby? Entonces, no le tienes que contestar, Gaby está molesta porque probablemente no entienda. Puede decir que, bueno, algo está pasando, pero ya voy a estar bien. Pero vos ves que esto es un drama que está sucediendo adentro, no lo estás comunicando.
So the two, in fact, that is exactly how it is. These two railway lines are parallel to each other, you know, they don't cross over into the other one. The track for the right side wheels is distinctly separate from the track of the left side wheels. The track of the right side wheel is the knower, and the track of the left side wheels is the kriya shield activity. This is the kriya going on. And the niyabla is now gone, you see. The niyabla was removed in the Gnanvidhi, and with more satsang and with more energies from the self and the Dada Bhagwan within. You see, the Dada Bhagwan within. This niyabla cannot touch you. You see, even though it feels as if, oh, he's bothering me so much, or she's, you know, how long will the abuse go on? All of those things. There is this awareness that this is an effect that. And no effect is eternal. Every effect is temporary. Every effect changes. Right, Gavi? Every effect changes. Today you might, yesterday you might feel, oh, it's terrible. Today you'll say, well, no, it's not so terrible. And then a little later you'll say, ah, no big deal, you see? So,
No, sorry.
Oh, sorry, go
Por
on.
ejemplo, las vías del tren no se cruzan jamás y la vía derecha no es la misma que la izquierda. La vía de la izquierda es la del observador y la del conocedor y la derecha es el kriyashil. Y esta es la niebla, ¿no? Es por la niebla, pero esta niebla se removió en el Dhanvidhi, en los satsang. Y sobre todo porque Dada está en ti y la niebla no te toca. Y es tener conciencia de que el efecto que suceda es temporal y cambia. Es como, por ejemplo, podrías decir, ayer tu día fue terrible, hoy está mejor. Y después de un rato vas a decir, está todo bien, ¿no? Tus efectos van cambiando.
¿Duda? ¿Y cuál es? Esta semana sucedió que llegaron en distintos momentos circunstancias de otros mahatmas cercanos a mí con esta sensación de aprovechamiento, de abuso, y no fue una persona, fueron en simultáneo como por lo menos cinco personas. Entonces, yo digo, ¿cuál es el misterio como que se desenvuelve ahí de que Dada, de alguna manera, Diego nos tiene sincronizados a todos viendo o sufriendo como o experimentando las descargas en una sintonía similar, o es que yo estoy atrayendo, mi energía está atrayendo esas circunstancias que son equivalentes a la mía, en definitiva.
El efecto espejo, decís.
Claro, ¿por qué
Ah.
se da esa sincronía? Porque
Ah.
son, han sido, y particularmente es que son mahatmas.
Okay.
Entonces es como, yo digo, ¿qué, cuál es el misterio que se
Ah.
desentraña ahí?
And she has another question. This week to Gabi happened that more or less five Mahatmas came to her with con esto de abuso, ¿no?
Claro, con
O
esta
pedido.
sensación de sentirse abusados
And
o aprovechados.
Gabi felt that she was abused or used, and she wants to know why it's happening this all together in the same week, because there were Mahatmas, ¿no? The this is happening all together to them, all the Mahatmas, and or is her energy that attract the like a mirror? Is she projecting that?
What is the mystery in this?
Ese the view, the seeing is associated with some negativity. What happened between Mahatmas? Is something that Gavi looks forward to. She's alone usually, and when Mahatmas come, there is something very magnificent. These are all awakened, enlightened ones of Dada. So there is zero room for seeing anything negative in them. There must be something that now Gavi is seeing which is negative, and being projected onto those other people, you see. All, otherwise, and the nature of seeing something negative is such that it's like you zero in only on that. It's like a big bee that just goes straight to the flower, you see. It just, wherever it might be, it just zeroes on, it just focuses on the negative so that you forget the beauty of the garden completely, you see. Not all five of them are negative. And then the word abuse is a very strong word. Instead, it is just that you felt like you were taken advantage of, they took advantage of your good nature or your hospitality or whatever you want to say, you see. But whatever comes to you is your own that has come, you see. And there is no fault of any one of them. The negative feelings that resulted are only the result of how Gavi is seeing it, you see. How Gavi is seeing it. The results within that happen in all the other five ladies or men who are there is highly individualized, and you it's not for us, you as the knower, to really kind of worry about the pudgal. What did he do, or what did she do, or what did she do, or just you don't you're not allowed to look in that direction anymore. You are just to see what happened inside Gabi. Why is Gabi so upset about this, you see? It is a And the answers are inside, my dear. The answers are not outside. The answers to this are not outside. The answers are just like turning the head in down, looking at the heart, looking at looking at what happened as Gnaya rather than and that associated with an opinion, you see. Gnaya is a very big word, you know, Gnaya. Gnaya means no ragdesh, you see.
Sorry, Neya means
No
no.
ragdvesh, no attachment,
Ah,
no
okay,
aggression.
yes. Okay, thank you.
You
Thank
see,
you.
no ragdvesh. You see, just this gneya, before we used to, whatever we saw, and usually through the intellect, was associated with attachment or aversion. What a beautiful time I had, they were here. Oh, they were so wonderful. Or why did this lady do this? Or why did this person do this? Or why, you know, so you see, so it was either positive or negative. The positive is fine, we are not touching it. But the negative part needs to be seen as happening to Gavi, not to you. It happened to Gavi, not to you. And you are there to help Gavi to see it as it is. So when you, the awakened one, is Gnan Swarup, is in a knowledge state, the awakened Swarup, with all its light falling on Gavi, will help Gavi see it more clearly. You see, Gabi cannot see it clearly. You have to see. You have to use your light to let Gabi see it clearly. You see, you see, you see, yeah.
Yes. Bueno, esto que está ver, ¿no? Esto que está asociado con los mahatmas, ¿no? Como esta mirada con negatividad con mahatmas. Es un espacio que hay que ver, que hay que ver, ¿no? La propia negatividad de Gaby que está siendo proyectada, ¿no? Es cómo pones el foco en lo negativo. Es como, por ejemplo, una abeja en un jardín ve una flor y va zoom, así, enfocada en la flor, va ahí directo. Y usar la palabra abuso es una palabra fuerte, ¿no? Como de alguna manera, como hacen, como qué pasa con tu hospitalidad, que la gente se acerca, ¿no? Y todo lo que te venga es tuyo, todo esto te pertenece. Y es algo muy importante poder ver a todos sin faltas. Y observar los sentimientos negativos de Gaby, ver eso. Y cuando estás en el conocedor, es qué es lo que Gaby hizo, qué es lo que Gaby mira, ¿no? Estar en el conocedor y ver a Gaby qué es lo que le pasa. Esto es solamente de Gaby, ¿no? Y la respuesta siempre va a estar adentro tuyo. Mira tu corazón, sin apego y sin aversión, todo está más ligado a las opiniones, ¿no? Y lo que sea que veamos es apego o aversión, es neya. Cuando decís algo que es lindo, que buen momento, cuando decís cosas positivas, está bien, eso déjalo. Pero cuando ponemos la atención en las cosas negativas que hace la gente, eso sí necesita ser visto. Necesita ser visto en qué es lo que le está sucediendo a Gaby. Y en el estado del conocedor es el estado donde toda la luz va a ayudar a Gaby a que pueda ver con absoluta claridad.
Ahora, acepto la respuesta pero no era esa la pregunta. Yo no los vi a ellos abusándome. Me pasa que fueron mahatmas que llegaron con situaciones puntuales de ellos, donde ellos se estaban sintiendo abusados por una situación particular que me la contaron. Cada uno,
No.
independientemente, tenía una
No, no.
situación puntual en que habían sido o se habían sentido abusados.
No, yo entendí que era
No que
vos.
yo lo había visto, que me estaban avisando a mí por contármelo, ¿ya?
Okay.
Entonces
So sorry,
me pareció
Judah. So
especial
sorry.
que llegaran
This
todos juntos en
what
un momento
she
determinado.
said. I misunderstood Gabby, and the question is that five Mahatmas come to her life, to her, with different situations of being abused. Not is not what
Gabi
happened to
was
her. The
okay.
five Mahatmas went to her, telling her about this.
Oh, I see. Okay. Oh, it totally changes
Completely different. So sorry. So sorry. Because I was.
the
Because
pero por algo me llegó esa
for a
respuesta
sec
en todo caso.
for a second I was wondering what is Gabi saying, but I didn't, you know. All right, okay, all right, you know, all right. So let us go reverse, you know, because the question, you know, now let us look at the question. Let's look at it this way.
Claro, lo
So
vamos a ver de esta manera porque dije,
five
cuando le llevo la
Mahatmas
pregunta.
came to Gabi and kind of unloaded. Otherwise, you know, the other technical word is vomit, their history of pain from the past, abuse, mistreatment, horrible things happening that happened in the past, you see. And they opened up to Gabi. All right, now. All right, so, okay. And Gabi, on listening to them, got affected, right? It affected Gabi, right? Or it didn't affect Gabi. Did it
¿Te sentiste
affect?
afectada, Gaby, debido a esto?
No. Pero
No,
no
no,
me
sí.
sentí que no tuve respuestas, como, o sea, como que no supe cómo, si hacerlo desde la Mahatma, si apoyarlo desde el relativo, como que se me generó un.
She wasn't affected, but she didn't know how to. If answer like a Mahatma or help them in the relative.
No, you know, play the drama. Play the drama. Oh, my dear, I'm so sorry this happened to you. Those human beings just want some therapy, expressive therapy, you see. They want to say something, and if one, like supposing five Mahatmas, one person starts speaking her story, then the other it triggers the other person. I want to tell my story too. You know, this is mind is Kriyashil. It's all constantly involved in activities, and it follows the leads of the scientific circumstantial evidence. Evidence this one, evidence of depression and sob stories and crying over somebody else's shoulder about what happened, blah blah blah, etc. continues. So another one. It's a drama. Look, those people, if you listen to them very seriously, in the night they're all asleep, completely asleep, soundly asleep. And Gabi is awake, wondering, oh my word, this happened to them. The world, after all the abuse, goes to bed. You see, they sleep, you see. And we, you know, it goes to sleep. Yeah, it'll make a lot of noise, you know, while it'll make, but then it goes to sleep, you see. This is prakriti. Yeah. This is discharge in prakritis. You see, Do not take it for real. There is nothing real about it. Yeah. The question you'll be asked the question: what is not real? There's nothing real about it. It's relative and circumstantial. It is related to circumstances. And it is highly modified by the intellect and the ego. The person who is relating it will embellish it and pour gasoline over her own story to make it more, whoa, appealing, you know, more impressive. Yeah, this is, you know, these are, and especially their Mahatmas, you know, you don't need to worry about Mahatmas. I'm sorry, this is a long answer, but you know, the simple answer is play the drama. You shouldn't say, oh, this is your vyavasthit, this is in your account, this is your karma account. You're giving scientific answers. What you need to say is, my dear, I'm so sorry, you know. You know, But you're fine right now, you're fine. You know, that's history, it's gone. And just because it has happened doesn't mean it is going to happen again. Except when they are in an abusive relationship, then, the file two or whatever their file is, continues to abuse them. That then you need to start a Me Too, a women's movement, Gabi as a leader and, everybody else following your instructions.
Yes. Bueno, lo primero que nada, cuando vienen, les decís, te cuentan, decís, la verdad lo lamento muchísimo. Y sucede que por ahí una persona viene y te habla y la otra persona también. Y es como que buscan terapia, ¿no? Y tenés que verlo como el Cría Shield de las evidencias circunstanciales. Y que todo esto es un drama. Después todas las personas te contaron, después se van, se quedan tranquilas, se duermen y vos te quedaste pensando a la noche, ¿no? Cuando todo esto simplemente es una descarga en Prakruti y nada es real. Todo está en lo relativo y en lo circunstancial. Y a veces querer entrar en lo explicativo tiene que ver con lo intelectual, ¿no? Entonces, no te preocupes por los mahatmas. Le decís, bueno, ahora estás bien, esto se terminó, se va a terminar, y en algún momento se va a terminar. Por ahí, en caso de que venga alguien y te diga, sí, mira, está habiendo abuso por esto, bueno, entonces ahí salís y le das las instrucciones.
Yeah, you see this. My dear, there is no human being in this world who is not subject to use abuse. Normal use of a human being is the appreciation of that used to exist many, many years ago on this earth of ours, but now it's over. Now we are in Kali Yuga, you see. There is even the most decent appearing person is in the process of abusing something or the other, you see. This is not a safe world now, and it's getting worse, you see. So use and abuse is the nature of the effects of this Kali Yuga, you see. And it is the direct result of just exponentially multiplying effects of more kashas in more effects. More effects, more kashas, more effects, if not in this life, then in the next life to come, you see. These are words of Dada, my dear, And to be able to see that it only stops when one realizes, who am I in all of this world? Who am I? And what am I? And we have now the exact answers of both of these questions. I am, in all of this use and abuse world, I am not doing anything. I am a kriya. I have no capacity to do anything. I have no capacity to change anything. It is only at the relative level, some of this knowledge of the good versus the bad comes in, and that, you follow the Navakalam path, you see, the Navakalam path, the path of nine columns, you see. Otherwise, you get the most horrible stories everywhere around. Anybody you know, sometimes most people hide the bad things. But it somebody or the other they open it up to, like some opened up to Gabi, right?
Yes. Bueno, nosotros estamos viviendo, en este momento estamos viviendo en la época de Kali Yuga, donde hasta la persona, todas las personas de alguna manera hacen abuso, ¿no? Y todo esto es efecto de la época que estamos viviendo. hasta el que mejor se ve también hace abusos, ¿no? Y cuanto más efectos, más calláis, vamos a estar creando para la próxima vida. Pero lo importante, lo más importante, es saber quién soy yo y qué es lo que soy. Y que en realidad yo no estoy haciendo absolutamente nada, no puedo cambiar absolutamente nada. Yo no tengo, no soy, no tengo actividad. Estás en el camino, estamos en el camino de los 9 Kalams y hay historias horribles que le va a pasar a las personas. Algunos se las guardan y no las dicen, y otros las cuentan, las comparten y las comparten con Gaby.
This is a very big chapter, my dear, because you see, I don't know whether it was with you or with the other group, but we just recently covered a heading called This Meghnaan. This Meghnaan is magnificent. This Meghnaan is magnificent, you see? And yeah, it was with the other group. Yeah, the Portuguese group. But anyway, Dadashree says this science is so magnificent. Why? He then immediately gives the reason why it is so magnificent. And he says it's because despite the presence of these horrible kashais, and we know how poisonous and dangerous these kashais are. Anger, pride, deceit, greed, and the combination of these. And despite the presence of these kashais, Gnan has arisen, they said. The I, the blissful I, the Gnan Swarup has arisen, you see. And that is the wonder of all the wonders of the world, you see. We can count each one of us. It has happened within each one of us. In what is other, what is otherwise known as absolutely impossible, the most magnificent event thing has happened, you see. Yeah, it has happened. And this. You started with this question. This is these kashais, the awareness is I'm no longer. These kashais are not mine. They belong to the Pudgal, to that which was filled. If this was filled with anger, 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 then the little effect will be anger, 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 anger in this life, you see. But this is a mixture. So mixture, mixture, mixture of all four. Mixture, mixture, mixture of all four unfolding. No more mine or yours, you see. Pudgal. Pudgal. Yeah. Purangala. And that which was filled is emptying. All right. So, yes, when Gabi listens to those ladies, you go into the dual mode. Gabi is listening to their story. And you are saying that Amapura, Amapura. And therefore, now saying what was filled inside this lady has unfolded, you see. And now she is coming and again crying over it because she is not a strong Mahatma, because she has not come to this level or number 80 satsang that we are talking about. We are at level 80, Every heading is a step for us, you see. Every satsang is absolutely magnificent because it just kind of lets us see it as it really is, you see. As it unfolds. And it becomes a gneya. Gneya means zero ragdvesh, you see.
Yes. Bueno, Dada dice que este Vignan es magnífico, ¿no? Esta ciencia es magnífica. ¿Y por qué? porque todos estos horribles cayaes y su combinación
Se me quedó en el fondo de casa.
se
Mataron. Perdón, perdón, perdón,
Okay,
perdón.
let
No.
us. Bueno, y vienen todos estos horribles cayáes y la combinación de estos cayáes, ¿no? Y a pesar de estos cayáes, y la bendición, la dicha surge, y es lo más importante esto, ¿no? Que suceda, que nos sucede a todos, qué es lo más maravilloso que sucedió, y esto es el conocimiento. El conocimiento de los cayáis, ¿no? Y sabes que el Pudgal se llenó de ira, mucha, mucha, mucha ira, y después va a descargar. Y esta es por la mezcla de lo mío, de lo tuyo, es lo que se llena, el Pudgal que se llena y se vacía. Entonces, Gaby, escucha, ve el alma pura. Y ve que lo que se llenó ahora está descargando, y ahora esta persona llora por esta descarga. Y este Mahatma por ahí no es tan fuerte, no estuvo siempre presente en los satsang, porque cada satsang es un paso y es un escalón para la conciencia, ¿no? De poder estar, de ver. Y poder vivir en ella, sin apego, sin aversión.
Yes, it's the human being of this current time period. Every human being has suffered so much, is suffering so much that everyone, all of them, need a shoulder to lay the head in. Head on and cry, you see. Just wants to get rid of all of this. So, suffered so much that it cannot tell anyone, he cannot say to anyone, you see. The man feels abused in the relationship because he says, I work so hard, to bring some money on the table, bread on, food on the table. I go from morning till evening. I take the abuse of the people at work and the people around me and all of those things. Come home only to find that now this wife of mine just gives me a little food and then orders me around. And, so the guy says he suffers and the woman says, what do I do? I sit here and, and this man, all he, eats a little food and then he uses my body without loving me. You see, now, I mean, what's going on? The answer is they cannot see the beauty of what is clearly in front of them. They cannot see it as it is. They are so involved in their own kashais, you see. Whereas you and I have been lifted up so that we see what is happening to Shuddha, to Gabi, to Damien. And now we see it as the activity of the mind, the activity of the body, the activity of the words, and deep inside. And we are not with any one of them. We do not identify, we do not, we are having a different, we are in a different field of knowledge, you see. Yeah. We are the free ones, you see.
Yes. Bueno, dice que acá todos los seres humanos, en este periodo de tiempo sufrimos y sufrimos mucho. Y algunos necesitamos un hombro para poder llorar, ¿no? Por ejemplo, hay un hombre que trabaja todo el día y en el trabajo no le pagan lo que corresponde o sufre alguna clase de abuso. Llega a la casa, cansado, con poco dinero, y la esposa le pone algo de comida sobre la mesa y le dice, tú usas mi cuerpo y lo usas sin amor. Y cada uno está involucrado con sus propias cosas, con lo que le está pasando, y no ven con claridad. Cada uno está envuelto en sus propios kayais. Y nosotros, los mahatmas, podemos ver la actividad de la mente, del cuerpo, de las palabras. Y por dentro no nos identificamos con eso, porque estamos en un campo de conocimiento diferente.
Yes, so you know, Gabi has a lot of space on her shoulders for Mahatmas to come and cry. Oh. But you see, that's the drama. You know, let Gabi be there for them, and once they empty, you see, once when you feel like vomiting, you see, you know, when you've got some wrong food inside, nature naturally your body will throw it out, you see. It's and you know this, and then there is a lot of relief, you see, you feel good after you vomit. And so it's all of these people, when they express it out, they take it out to someone who they respect, they love, they, you know, in the relative, they trust, then it is natural. So let it come out, they feel better, and yet you afterwards you return to the satsang in terms of not their story, but your own personal stories, you see. That, listen, my dear, you're not the, you know, I too, Gavi too, was abused, you know, felt abused. Not, there's a difference between being abused versus feeling abused, you see. And, you know, so you share some story of yours, but, you know, how you rose above those kashai effects with your own, with Dada's beautiful knowledge, you see. So now you kind of conclude that kind of meeting with satsang, you see. Satsang, reading a few pages of Dada's Flawless Vision book, you see. And everybody starts looking at, where am I wrong in this, you see. You know, it opens up the vision of the self, vision of the self, you see.
Gaby tiene las espaldas fuertes, ¿no? Para que las personas vengan a llorar en tu hombro, ¿no? Y las personas cuando confían y cuando respetan y pueden compartir esto, después se sienten bien y tú después volvés a satsang. Y puedes compartir alguna historia tuya. Y acá ayuda a hacer una diferencia entre sentirse abusado y ser abusado. Entonces, podemos compartir alguna historia personal y también hablar de los efectos de los kashais y volver a satsang o compartir una frase de la visión impecable, la visión del ser, siempre algo que nos traiga al conocimiento de Dada.
You see, and if this is the exact reality, and this use abuse effects that happen in to the body complex, to the Pudgal complex, to the Pudgal complex, use abuse, abuse, use abuse. From childhood all the way to the current adult life, you see, use abuse situations and state, even amidst all of that, I am avyabhad, I am beyond pain, I, my state and my reality is such that I can never hurt anyone, nor there is anything in this world that can hurt me. There is nothing in this world that can hurt me or touch me, you see. That is my state. So despite being this, why do I feel so used and so abused? I have to do all the work. I am, do I have to do this and do that? Then understand that that is the prakriti, that is the makeup of this complex that is identified as whatever the name is, you see. That is the prakriti. It is not you. You're not being subject to use or abuse. You're simply knowing the effects. And you have, with this sentence, mind, speech, and body are subject to abuse and use. I am avyapad. I am beyond pain. Because use and abuse lead to pain. Use doesn't lead to pain, but abuse, wrong use of it, leads to pain. If you have a knife, you see, you can use a knife to cut vegetables, but you see, that same knife can cut you too, so it has to be used. You see, that is abuse of the knife. If the knife is used to hurt others, it is abuse, you see.
El uso y el abuso tienen que ver con el complejo del cuerpo, desde la niñez hasta la adultez. Es una situación o un estado. Y yo estoy más allá de todo dolor. Mi realidad no puede ser tocada porque no puede ser tocada porque no. El uso y o el abuso es del prakruti. Entonces, no está sujeto a esto. Y uno puede sentir, por el abuso puede sentir dolor. Uno puede estar cortando verduras y cortarte con el cuchillo. Pero bueno, eso es del prakruti.
Yeah, so my friends, this, we are deeply grateful for these magnificent words of Dada that now arise within us at the level of experience. This, every word of Dada sits inside us as if as the exact bolt that fits, exact nut that fits into the bolt, you see, just locks it up, locks it up, locks it up. The right nut fits in, tighten it fits. You see, this is magnificent because then it locks us. It kind of prepares us as the pristine, unaffected Avyabhad Swarup that you and I really are, you see. We are, nothing can touch us, nothing can shake us, nothing can move us, and yet we continue to be aware of the nature of this prakriti, understand this prakriti, this one called Gavi, Shuddha, Sandra, etc. See, understand this prakriti.
Yes. Es toda la, todo esto, toda esta ciencia y todo este conocimiento realmente es tan perfecto que nos mantiene brillantes, y nada puede tocarnos y nada puede movernos, ¿no? Y es estar en la conciencia, en consciente de que esto es el prakruti y poder entender el prakruti.
So when is our Parayan starting? So, and if so, we meet if there is no Parayan, okay? Otherwise, if Parayan is going on Aptavani 14, then after the Parayan is over, we'll meet, okay? So we'll let
Okay.
Patricia know about this, huh?
Okay. Dice que cuando haya parayom, no vamos, los satsang van a parar y después van a volver a recomenzar y Yuda nos va a estar avisando. Thank you,
Pati,
Yuda. Beautiful satsang.
perdón, perdón, pero Alicia había hecho una pregunta y la mía se súper alargó y la de ella pareciera ser
Abusaste de Alicia.
Abusé,
A Luz,
la
que Luz
pusimos para
Laga.
la próxima, es que ya estamos en horario.
Okay.
La pasamos para la
Okay,
próxima, no hay
so
problema.
we leave the next question for the next time, Shuda. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Shudhakar.
All right. Who? Somebody had a question?
Yes, but she is not present at this moment.
Okay. All right. Okay. So other way. All right. So not a problem, huh? So should that Bhagwan.
Shudhakar, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Thank
Thank
you.
you.
Gracias a todos.
Gracias, Chitana,
Gracias,
gracias.
Mahatma.
Yes, so
Gracias,
wonderful
Mahatma.
to see everyone. Yeah. Hola, Tato. He's everyone just says, yay, Sachidanan. Everyone, Cecilia, Tenma, Angelique, everyone.
Yes.
Monica. Yay, Sachidanan, Rosie.
Sachidana,
Yeah, yay,
yay,
Sachidanan.
Sachidana.
Have a wonderful morning, huh?